Hello everyone, welcome to Repentino. In this session, we'll be discussing about few important points related to the interim budget. People who are attending different interviews can note down these important points. This is a very short video. We'll be making an elaborated video on allocations related to different sectors in one of our future videos. So let's start this session with agriculture. The government has allocated 75,000 crores for farmers under Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi. The farmers whose cultivating land is up to 5 acres will be eligible to get 6,000 rupees annually
for the development of northeastern regions.
The allocation has been 58,166 crores. This shows 21% increase from previous years. Under this, Rashtriya Kamadenu Ayog will be established for the welfare of cows in the country. Were eligible for the complete tax rebate. Now, this income level has been increased to 5 lakhs. That means if your income is below 5 lakh, then you do not need to pay any income tax. Standard deduction, which was 40,000 last year, has been increased to 50,000. TDS threshold on interest on bank and post office deposits has been increased to 40,000. TDS threshold on rental income has also been increased from 1.8 lakh to 2.4 lakhs. Coming to the educational sector, 38,572 crores has been allocated for the. This shows a 20% increase than previous year. Now, the government also plans 25% additional seats in educational institutions to meet the 10% reservation. It also plans to set up the 22nd AIIMS in Haryana. 60,000 crores has been allocated for MGNREGA. What is MGNREGA? It is Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. Railways to get a capital support of 64,587 crores. For the welfare of SCSTs, 76,800 crores has been allocated. The government plans to set up a national center for artificial intelligence. For this, AI portal is to be developed soon. Another important point, the defense budget has crossed over 3 lakh crore for the first time. The other important points are, the finance minister Piyush Goyal stated that to ensure clean banking, the successful 4R approach will be used. What are the 4Rs? Recognition, recapitalization, resolution and reform. The details of each of these allocations will be discussed in the coming videos. Next, fiscal deficit for 2018-19 is estimated at 3.4% of GDP. We are poised to become a $5 trillion economy in the next 5 years. We aspire to be a $10 trillion economy in the next 8 years. Finally, we can say that the government has concentrated on 3 crore middle class taxpayers considering the tax rebates and other things. Thank you. With this, we end this session.
If you like the video, please hit the like button, comment, and share it with your friends. Also, don't forget to subscribe for all our future videos.